Finally, after all the planning and traveling, we're here. I can't wait to get this journey underway. Scout, my loyal companion, has been whining in anticipation since we pulled into this small parking lot, where I will leave my car for the next few days. Today, Scout and I will cross over frozen lakes and snowy forests in an effort to find a place to camp deep in the wilderness. I'm pulling behind me a sled full of gear that I chose to bring on this particular trip. The hot tent and stove will keep us warm and cook our food. The axe and saw will help gather wood to fuel the stove and outdoor fire. My pots and pans will help me gather and melt snow for drinking water and cook my food easily. I have more than enough food for Scout and I, a book to help pass the time in the long winter nights, a notepad for writing my thoughts and ideas out here. Most of all, my dog, my old companion. He loves camping. He loves the winter, but most of all, he loves to be by my side, no matter what we're doing. This dog is something else. One of those once or twice in a lifetime type dogs. On to the adventure. I'm gonna have to leave the snowmobile track now. It continues on that way, and I gotta go up on that way to my first portage. Okay, I've come to my first portage. I have to go up that way, across the land. That should be fun. I gotta be really careful because of that open water there. So there's only a couple sketchy spots on my route here, but this is one of them, and I'm already past it, so that's good. Good news. Oh my God. Oh my God. The ground is ice underneath the snow and I can't get any purchase. And this thing is so heavy. Son of a bitch. Watch out, Scout. Move. Oh my God. Oh, so much work. I hate this sled. Move. Back on the ice. That was rough, man. I'm just past where I can not see my car now, and it's been over an hour. So I could see my car for over an hour trying to get this far. It's slow going, and I got the whole length as far as you can see, plus a couple more lakes to go. It's considerably warm. It's probably sitting at like -2 or -3 right now. In the next few days, the highest is going to get as +5. So I'm kind of sketched out by this ice situation. Let me show you what I'm dealing with right now. There's a layer of ice. And then there's another layer of ice. And that second layer of ice, that bottom layer, that's got to be pretty deep, pretty thick. Dig. Back up, back up, good boy. So I think I'm pretty safe anyway. That's why I have this pole, so I can kind of stab before I walk if I'm ever worried about it. Come on, buddy. Good boy. Scout keeps laying down, his paws all messed up. I keep digging snow out from in between his pad. I think that's the problem. I hope that's the only problem. Oh, I'm just about to get back onto the snowmobile tracks. I haven't been walking on those guys for like an hour now. It'll be a welcome change. Oh yeah. All right, coming up to some land again. I think this is where I'm gonna decide to camp. Alright guys, I'm exhausted. I've been going all day. I think I've finally found a suitable spot to camp for the next few days. I'm not even going to bother trying to get my sled up anymore. I've tried to pull it up this small incline here for about 10 minutes. I can't even get it up anymore. My forearms are done from lugging this sled all day up and downhill and stuff. There's absolutely no friction on the bottom, so it just slides back out whenever, if it's on a hill at all. So anyways, I'm just going to hand bomb the rest of my gear over to my campsite and gonna set up now. I've chosen this spot here. Very flat. The lake is like 20 feet that way. I have some trees to tie off to. There's nothing really big and dead overhead. My only real concern, and it's not even really, is this. It's dead, but it's broken off about 10 feet up. But I think I can push it over. Scout, come here. Come. I don't want to hit the dog. He's sit down. He's crazy over sticks. Okay, there, I feel a lot better about it now. I can use that for firewood, split it into pieces. Yeah, this will be my campsite, my home for the next few days. So this is my 9x9 canvas tent. My Atuk Kanguk. All right, getting somewhere.
throwing snow on this snow skirt at the bottom to keep the wind out, keep it nice and taut. This back peg wouldn't stake into the ground, so I've got to use a snow anchor kind of thing. Got to get a bunch of snow on that. Everything's pretty much done. It's 5 o'clock. I got about an hour light left, tops. Sun's going down. I'm tired, hungry. Scout's tired and hungry and cold. I'm getting cold too. I gotta go search around for firewood. Enough firewood to make this stove last all night. Well, not all night. I'm not gonna be using it in the middle of the night, but up until at least 10 o'clock tonight, so. I'm so drained. I got quite a few days here though, so I'm lucky. I don't have to have to rush anything. So off to get firewood.
This is a solid dead piece of oak. Need some great firewood. It's leaning that way.
Let's go, stop.
Gonna be good. All right, so I'm gonna get this fire going while I go collect more firewood. I'm gonna give it a good burnout while I'm not in here, just to clean it out as much as possible. I don't have any kind of birch bark that I see right around me, near me. I can go walk and find some tomorrow, but in this immediate area I don't see any. But I should just be able to light these twigs, these pine twigs, on fire with this Bic lighter. So you break the ends, light the ends, the broken pieces at the end, it'll accept the flame better. Then hold it straight up and down like that for a minute until it really grows. So I started the fire with pine twigs because they're easy to ignite and easy to collect. Then now I've moved on to hardwood. This is a maple. This was easy to collect as well. It just broke right off. So I've chopped down that one oak you saw. I have to get a lot more, but that one oak is super dense and it's going to get a lot of pieces out of it. And I don't really have to burn long pieces to stay warm in here with this wood stove. So that one oak might be 90% of my fuel for tonight. I gotta dry my gloves off. They're soaking wet from doing all this work. But the good thing is about this tent, I can dry things off at the top here in a matter of minutes. It's so hot already. We gotta strip down big time. Gotta love the hot tent.
I was able to fit all my gear into a duffel bag and this. Instead of two duffel bags, I brought this small Rubbermaid container. And here I got some food and notebook, books and stuff. But this is a cool piece of gear. This will stop my center pole from catching on fire or smoking. So all I'm gonna do is wrap this around my center pole. Stick it into the ground. Call it good.
This is a long day, guys. Real long. I'm exhausted. Going up and down the land parts when I wasn't traveling on the ice was so difficult. Just the inclines, I couldn't do it. Like, I had my rope was long enough I could hike to the top and try and just pull it up when I was at the top. But the problem was underneath the snow, even here, underneath the snow, there's ice, like a good couple inches of ice from melting and freezing again. And I couldn't get any purchase. My feet couldn't get any grip on the ground to pull. So I was pulling, I would slide. So what I had to end up doing was all like my forearms. I was bracing myself and just pulling in like this. It was exhausting. Very, very tiring. I don't even have energy to do anything tonight. I'm going to just cook up some dehydrated spaghetti here in the tent, read for a bit, and call it a night. I need to relax. I need to gain some energy back for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll go on a hike and set up camp a little better. Maybe build a bed in here, a seat, a bench where I can lay on. I brought lots of good food this trip. Stuff that'll take a while to cook and taste really good and stuff. But I knew the first day I was going to be exhausted, so I did bring one dehydrated meal. This is spaghetti. So I'm glad I did. I have no desire, want, or energy to make anything else. So I got my spaghetti. All I'm going to do is just fill it up with water right until right above the noodles, the spaghetti. And I'm going to put it right on top of the wood stove. I don't want to add too much water because the sauce is going to, if I have to dump some out, the sauce will get lost. So that's why I just add till the top, because I know that's not going to be too much. And if it's not enough, I can always add some more after. So this is my food bag. I'm gonna dump it out now to get rid of the things that I don't want to thaw, right? So the things I want to keep frozen or cold are gonna stay outside the tent. Got this heavy duty Hidden Woodsman stuff sack. So I'm not worried. I'm not worried about my food getting wet through that or anything. I'm not worried about animals because it's the winter time. The scout's here and he stinks like a dog and nobody's gonna come around. All right, a pizza, not pizza. Not having pizza. My spaghetti is done. It's dehydrated. I'm losing it. It's rehydrated perfectly. I'm just gonna put some Parmesan cheese on. Ha! It's very good. I'm very warm now. Let's go want some of this. You're having kibble tonight, bud. Straight kibble. Tomorrow I'll hook you up.
Just lay down your bed. You're too close to the stove. What are you doing? Lay down your bed. Good boy.
So these things get pretty cool. Just fit like the emergency candles in them. They unscrew from the bottom. This one's kind of low, but I do have an extra candle. Pretty neat little thing, and I can hang that from the top and get absolutely no light from it at all. Perfect. If I point the camera completely up at it, sure, fantastic, it looks cool and everything. But the fact of the matter is, that only lights up the top part of the tent. Let's try this again. Oh, ba-bam. There we go. Okay. So, the candle is cool. The candle lantern is cool if you're closer down to it, or if it's closer down to you. But other than that, it's not useful at all. So anyways, this cool ambient light will keep it up there. With this little flashlight I got next to me, stick it in the ground, and I'll be able to film with that light. I'll be able to read from it and all that stuff too. So. I do have my headlamp as well. No shortage of lights. It's hot. What am I doing? I had a subscriber send me some fireman gloves. Really generous of them. Thank you very much. I only brought one on this trip because I don't need to. But for working in the wood stove and picking up hot stuff and all that, perfect. Just laying here reading a really cool book. Buddy Clint let me borrow. It's called Alone Against the North. Started reading it a long time ago. Never finished it. I'm picking it back up. It's really cool. Very interesting boat exploration. This is a flask with a heart on it. Got some Bowmore in here. Bowmore, it's a 12-year-old scotch. Another Islay scotch, I think it's called. I think that's how you pronounce it. So cheers, guys. I got a few people giving me a little bit of hints, little scotch connoisseurs getting in the comments saying that I should really not just drink it down, more swirl it in my mouth and try to taste it a little bit more. So I do keep it warm now too. This is pretty good. It's not as good as that Leg of Woolen, but it's half the price. So it was doable. I'm letting that fire die down, and I'm heading to bed. I'll see you guys in the morning. I need some sleep. Good night. Good morning. I slept really good, guys. I let that fire die down at like, I don't know, around 10 o'clock. I just stayed in bed. I slept until 7:30. Super refreshed, raring to go, hungry.
You hungry? Want some food?
My breakfast is done. It smells super good. So I gotta give Scout some, right? At least that's what people tell me. I gotta feed him. So we're gonna grab 2 sausages. I cooked 6. He's gonna get 2 and some kibble. And I'll have to cut them up for him because they're piping hot. Scout's hot, buddy. Just wait a minute. Back up.
There you go, buddy.
Good boy. Got a good sausage. Can't be too hot, you're wolfing it down. Wolfing it. Well, it's 9 in the morning, and I feel like exploring. So I'm gonna bring the camera, bring my backpack, and the dog, and we'll go out for a few hours.
Heard a gunshot. Hear that?
Could be hunting rabbit, maybe? Anyways. Walking across this lake, I'm gonna go up into the woods over here in front of me. I'm going to go try to find an old shelter I built about 2-3 months ago. Hopefully it's still there, hopefully I can find it. The snow is about 8 inches deep, and then there's a layer of crust, and then there's some more snow, but it's okay. I'm able to walk without snowshoes here in the bush. Which is helpful. It's a pain in the butt walking with snowshoes sometimes. This is pretty cool, guys. Oh, you can see how much it snowed. My feet normally would be, my legs would be at like a sitting position. Stay dry inside. It's ready to be used right now. I'm pretty impressed. Pretty happy I found it. From this angle, you can really see how much snow is on top of the lean-to and how much it protected and it stopped the snow from going inside the lean-to. Sure, a little bit got in, you know what I mean? That's obviously gonna happen, but the meat of the bed, like 90% of it's completely snow free, and it's been melting and snowing and thawing and freezing, but pretty cool. The shelter is good in my book. I think I'm gonna keep hiking around now. I got a lot of work to do at the camp, but I got a few days and I can do it even later on today. I'll show you what I have to do there, but basically I want to build a bed and some other things. But Scout's raring to go. He doesn't want to sit here. And I kind of want to explore on the lakes and stuff. Well, I can. You know, it's easy walking on the lakes. Back in here,
After I said that, it wasn't so bad walking. I kept sinking like, down past. I'm all wet up to my knees. It's supposed to get up to around 5 degrees today. It's not feeling like 5 right now. It's feeling like a couple degrees below 0 Celsius. But, you big guy. Yeah, we're going to go walk around and walk.
Scout and I continue to hike for 3 hours, exploring the forest and lakes surrounding our camp. Feeling satisfied with the energy spent on the hike and the ever-present camp chores in the back of my mind, I decide to head back to camp, where we will make lunch and get started on the chores.
Let me show you a very big problem. Must be in a very low-lying area. It's hard to tell because of the snow, obviously. And there was a layer of a bunch of snow and then a layer of ice and then water or ice underneath too, and then it melted. But like, that's straight water, an inch and a half deep, all under my tent. You know what I mean? Underneath the wood stove, underneath where I'm sleeping, everything.
It's a lot of work to set this tent up. I'm not moving. It's just, if I move, I'm going. You know what I mean? I'm not taking this down and setting it up in a different spot. So I have to come up with a solution. I thought about packing it with snow, but all that's going to do is when that snow melts, it's going to make that water higher. I think I'm going to get logs. There's tons of dead wood around here. There's no campsites around here. You know what I mean? There's a plethora of dead wood. So I think I'm going to, as well as get firewood, get wood to stack in here. Wind and the sun will dry these off nicely and keep them out of the way and off the snow while I work in there. Here's a dead pine. Pine doesn't make the greatest firewood, especially when I have access to oak and maple around. So I'm going to take this down and use this for my floor. So I need about four saw lengths for the piece the size that I need. We'll bring it on over and check it out. So what this is going to do is stop me from walking and caving this in anymore. It's going to block some of the heat because if you notice, right underneath the stove I've got logs. And right underneath the stove has not melted, but off the side has. So these should absorb a lot of the heat and transfer it. That's my theory anyway. We'll see, I guess. Man, that sucks. It's super warm. It's positive 6 degrees Celsius right now. I hope this doesn't keep up. Things are melting. My Rubbermaid container is getting dripped on from snow above. I hope this doesn't keep up. Too many days like this is not good when I gotta walk over the ice. positive 6. It's February. Crazy.
All right, I'm satisfied with my floor. It's gonna do the job, I believe. But let me take you in and show you what I do need to do. Here is where I laid, like this. Well, there's a slant going down towards the stove, obviously because it's melting that way. So I need to fix that problem. I think I'm gonna build a bench. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Yep. Alright. We're in business. I wanna trim this pine up real good because my sleeping pad on top of it. The last thing I want is to puncture my sleeping pad. I'm lucky this dead pine is readily available around here. I don't even have to walk far to get it. There we go. Leave my sleeping pad out there for a little bit longer. I just want to mash down any kind of knots or pokey parts that'll be on here so I don't poke my my pad, but I do have my Reflectix down, so that's an extra buffer. But this is good, this is a good height. I'm not hunched over too much, my knees. I could be tall, I could be higher up, but it's not so bad. I'll be really close to the fire for warmth, or for the stove for warmth. If I get too cold, too warm, I can lay down. On this side, it's kind of on a diagonal away from the fire. You can feed the fire from sitting here. Pretty good. Go.
It's up near 10 degrees Celsius, plus 10 degrees Celsius, which is around 50 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know what I'm going to do. They're calling for 5 today, 5 tomorrow. If it's 10 today, if it's 10 tomorrow, what do I do? Is the ice still safe? I honestly don't know. There's snow on the ice, which would insulate it from the sun. Everything's slush. I'm walking around. It's just soaking wet. I had planned on wearing my hiking boots with gaiters, and I'm glad I didn't because they would be just drenched. These muck boots are drenched. Everything's drenched. It's freaking... I wanted a winter. I wanted a winter camp with Scout. I wanted like a negative 10 in the day, negative 20, negative 30 at night, so that my canvas tent is useful. Right, I got this wood stove in here. I'm dying. I put a little bit of wood in there. I gotta freaking take off my shirt. It's way, way too hot. I don't need a canvas tent with this temperature. Not cool at all. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I might only stay another couple nights. Crazy. You got all these plans, what you want to do, and weather can change everything very quickly. And I've learned it before. I know that lesson.
These are the snow conditions. You can see just how slushy it is.
That stick. Get that stick. Where is he? Get it. Get that stick.
Get it. Arr. Arr. Get it. Arr. Good boy. This is rock tripe, and as disgusting as it looks, you can actually eat it. Almost zero nutritional value in it, but is edible. I made it to the top. The lake's behind me. Super windy, guys. I don't know what's going on. There's not a cloud in the sky. Blowing warm air in, I think. But I'm not cold, I'll tell you that much. No shirt underneath my sweater, no toque, no long johns, no insulated boots. Oh, it's windy. All right, let's get going, bud. Go on. I'm coming. Go. Don't worry, buddy. Go on. I'm coming. Go. 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 You want me to go first? This is super dense oak. Pieces that are too small to saw or cut or break the other way, we'll just cut them like this. Watch out, bud. Go on, Scoop. Good boy. Blocking the camera, homie. Decided to come down to the lake and check out the situation of the snow and the ice. So it was like 8 to 10 inches thick when I came in the snow. Now it's like 3 inches. Don't get me wrong, it's still solid underneath. Like, move, Scoop. Watch out, buddy. Solid. Thank you. beautiful outside. It's that golden hour. The sun's going down. Nice and warm, obviously. I'm getting hungry, so I'm just stoking that fire up. Gonna get some food. I think tonight I'm gonna make a stir fry. Some potatoes, onions, garlic, sausage. Oh, and bean sprouts. Are these bean sprouts? Whatever these are. My wife gave them to me. They're frozen. It's gonna be a little nasty. I brought a red pepper too, but that was a bad idea. It froze and then juiced all over the place. For my potatoes, I'm gonna do parboiled, which means I'm going to boil them halfway and then cut them up and put them with my stir fry, because if I don't do that, then they're not going to be cooked by the time the rest of the things in the stir fry are cooked. So, oh, piss. So how I do the parboiled potato is I have a pot of water, cold water. I'm gonna put them in cold water. And then I'm gonna bring that water to a boil. And as soon as that water boils, I'm gonna take them off, let it cool down, and then cut them up. So I got my sausage all cut up. It's not looking like it's the best quality sausage. I've not got this kind before, but it looked good in the package. Oh well. Just putting some garlic in now. I got 5 pieces of garlic to put in. So pretty garlicky, but I like garlic a lot. And then also some onion, which I'm just trying to warm up over the wood stove right now. And there she is without the potatoes, missing some color without that red pepper too, but that's okay. I'm sure it'll be really good. I'm gonna just set it on now and let it warm up as the potatoes are boiling. They're all floating now. Nice and easy. I'll have potato water to drink. Lovely. I'm gonna slice them relatively thin. That way I'm assured they will cook. They're super hot. Hot potato, guys. Hot potato. Oh, man. I gotta wait a minute. Or use my spork. Haha. That's using the old noggin, Joe. Give him his own full sausage on top of his kibble in the hopes that he will eat some kibble as well. There you go, bud. Dig in. That's looking pretty good. I think she's done. Did you eat all your food already, bud? Go eat your kibble. Has onions in it, and I'm not giving any to him. All right, she looks good. A little taste test. Some potato, onion, garlic, sausage, all in one. Cheers, guys. That's good. That's really good. The potatoes are done, which I'm happy about. A lot of times it's hard to cook the potatoes cooked. Really good. So I brought one beer with me. I think I want to drink it. This one is called Square Ale Pale Ale.
Cheers. Mmm. That's a pretty decent IPA. This one is from the Republican House, which is in Peterborough. It's pretty good. 5.5%, not too strong. But very tasty. Super happy with that. Good food, good brew. Good company. Hey, bub. Screw you, Joe. Well, as you can probably tell through the graininess of the video, we're losing light now. I set up a GoPro to get a time lapse of the sunset. It was a pretty nice sunset tonight, so let's go walk down and grab my GoPro, grab my firewood, and hunker down for the night. I'm starting to chill down. It's starting to get less than 10 degrees Celsius. Well, the light stopped beeping on it, so I'm hoping it recorded. I'm sure it just stopped recording after about 20 minutes or so, but... Oh! Hello! What a beautiful sky! Oh, man. Look at the hole through my ear. Derp-de-derp-derp-derp. Oh, tonight's gonna be nice. There's no clouds. There's not a cloud in the sky. So I think I'm going to try to do some night photography. Try to get some stars on film and video. Well, picture and video. That beer was only 5.5%, I swear. Well, I think I might read for a little bit. I'm gonna wait. I'll have a little nip of some scotch in a couple hours. Keep on this fire. It's nice and cozy in here now. I like the raised bed. Feels like almost like a cot. I mean, I'm off the ground. No peasant life for Joe. I think I'm gonna make myself up some hot chocolate. So I got my potato water that I boiled my potatoes in. Almost full. My heavy cover canteen cup. I'm gonna boil that up. And then I have this fancy Starbucks hot cocoa chocolat chaud. Yeah. From Algonquin Outfitters for some reason. Super long time ago. I think I bought it when the family and I went to Algonquin Park in August. Never used it. Never made it. So I'll make it up. It's fancy. It's fancy pants. You know what? I'm gonna break out the M&M peanuts too. Have a grand old time. Mmm. Balling out of control, boys and girls.
I've just been able to keep this the damper right open and the door open as well. And it's staying nice and warm. And when I need to crank the heat up, I just close the door, close the damper, and it heats up in here within a matter of minutes. It's too hot in here again. Close that damper. I shouldn't have. I'm gonna vent it. I'm gonna open the door and vent it out a little bit so I don't get overheated again. smells so chocolatey. Smells super good. Oh, that's not good. Seems as though what happened on the other side of the wood stove is happening over here now. You saw it dripping underneath Scout's paw. His blanket is soaked. It's laying in the water now. That sucks. I had no idea. I had no idea that this was like a... I don't even know, like a dip. A dip in the ground, I guess. A big dip. I was just trying to find a flat spot with trees around to tie off to. This looks flattish. This is a weird thing happening. I've never had this happen before. I've had the whole ground turn to ice before and melt and freeze and melt and freeze from the heat. But there's literally a layer of ice and then like a drop of 4 inches and then water. I don't know what to do. I'm not moving the tent. I'm not moving the tent. If I take this tent down, I'm leaving. That's for sure. It's really not good. Fancy ass Starbucks
hot chocolate.
That's bitter. That's no good. And I like dark chocolate too. That's not bitter. Cheers. Yes, I have a white flask with a heart. It's not going to get any more dark. So let's go on out and see what the star and the moon situation is like. There's a ton of stars in the sky. My video will not pick it up. Maybe I can get it on a picture. Cheers. This will be the last one. This will be my nightcap. I'm going to bed real soon. Well, today was good. I feel like I got a lot accomplished. Big ol' hike. Built a bed. Built the floor over there. Cut a lot of firewood. Cooked good food. Good meals. We got bugs. Alright, folks. I'm headed to bed. I'll see you in the morning. Just looking around my camp here, and I did pick a higher up spot than the rest of the surrounding area, to be honest. Let's look at it. So next to it, 5 feet away from my tent, there's a low-lying area there. I come around the back, and it's the same thing on the back and the other side. Actually, there's like a stream or something right here. Look. Not a stream, just stagnant water. But sitting there. So all here, all behind, on the side, in front is high, And right where I'm camping is higher up. But nonetheless, it still must be a low spot because of all the water underneath my tent. It's just getting worse. And with the warm weather and the more fires I have in the wood stove, it's going to become unhospitable to live in, uninhabitable even. Let's go inside, I'll show you the rest of it. Well, as you can see, I'm living in this. I have to walk all through this just to sit down. If I didn't have my raised bed, I'd be laying in this. So, see that? The stove is resting on. Has like nothing left. Nothing stable anymore. That stove could fall, the ice can collapse underneath it. Even the center pole could go, nothing is safe. Like I said, it's just gonna get worse with the more fires I have, so. I'm gonna bail, I'm gonna go today. It's a lesson learned. That's the thing too, I brought the shovel to like shovel it out, but then I figured, oh, it's gonna be unlevel ground if I do that. So I'll just pack the snow down, scrape some out, make it level. I had no idea there was just going to be this depression underneath my tent. How do you know? How do you know, honestly? Unless you're like up on a hill in the wintertime, or if you know the area. That sucks. I wanted to spend a few more days here, but it's okay. It's no big deal. I think what I'm going to do is take the family on a winter camp now. I think I'm going to go home a couple of days early and take my wife and my daughter and my dog in the hot tent to a different spot. So, yeah, that's what we'll do with our time. I'm gonna make some pancakes up this morning. These are the Just Add Water pancakes. You wanna make them a little bit runny because they tend to thicken up. You know it's time to flip it when it's got all these holes on top. Ba-bam, son. Look at that piece. Ready for my Canadian-ness to come out? Oh, yeah. Fill in all the little holes with syrup. Syrup fingers. These are some of the best pancakes I've ever had. Probably because I made them. It's nice to be able to take my time in the day, in the morning and stuff. Normally I'm moving. I'm eating oatmeal, or I'm trying to get out there quick. Eating oatmeal or bars for breakfast. These past two breakfasts have been nice. Sausage and eggs, pancakes. Melted snow is a constant job out here. Pour it into my canteen without spilling it on my hands. So I'm gonna fill this up again and get a full canteen. What do you think, Scope? Is it time to go? You wanna go home? Yeah? Well, it seems like the scooter even wants to go. I'm just melting some more snow to collect water for my hike out. I'm gonna let this fire die down and tear down camp.
This is the only piece of ice left, not even snow, but ice, that hadn't caved in where the wood stove was. I bet if I stay one more night in this spot and have my wood stove going, this would all melt it out too, which means the wood stove falls down, the stovepipe falls, and potentially this falls, the main support. Like, look at that, not even barely anything holding it on. This just wasn't safe anymore. I'm making the right call, I know it. Yeah. Thick ice. A thick sheet of ice. And then all this water. Learning experience, big time, guys. I don't want the tent to fall in the water inside there, because then it'll make drying it out and putting it away even harder. So I'm going to attempt to take it down, make it fall to the side, and grab it before it goes into the water, hopefully. Bad. I think it got wet a bit. That's not too bad. You can really see the footprint of the tent now, which isn't very big at all. Scout slept here and melted this snow down here. So this is where all the room Scout had left was right here. Right? Or else he was in the water. I had a little bit of storage here. My bed was here. And I had a little bit of firewood here. And then the debacle, the freaking Lake Joe underneath my feet here. So this tent packs down really small, but in order for it to pack down small, you have to fold it up correctly. And it's kind of a pain in the butt. It's got these five seams. You gotta get all the seams together as best you can. Watch out, Scout, move. Then fold this side over just a bit to make it straight, rectangular even. Make sure all the sticks aren't caught. Well, it's not as small as it was when I started, but it should still fit on the sled fine. I turned my sled around to face the direction that I'm going to be going when I leave, so that I don't have to try and turn it around with the gear on it. Pretty sweet cover to go on top of it, just to keep everything secured, keep out the snow, all that fun stuff. Yeah, look at this. Now I have to deal with rocks and ground. It's not even snow anymore. Is no good. No good for the sled, that's for sure. Oh, gotta love that sound.
The snowmobile track turned to ice. It's like, it's too slick to walk on. I can't get any grip. But if I walk next to it on this other pack down part from the throw or maybe the one of their skis, I can get grip, and my sled slides on the ice frictionless. Watch this. So that's pretty good. Making good work of it.
What a beauty day. I'm out in the middle of a lake. The sun is shining. Just getting to that part of the day where it's really warm now. It's gotta be +5 at least. Man, I'm not in a hurry. I think I'm gonna stop here and have a lunch right in the middle of this lake. Nice healthy lunch, M&M peanuts. It's so peaceful out here. Wispy clouds, two different types of clouds. Wispy clouds and another kind of wispy cloud actually. A little bit of a breeze. Not too bad though. It's a nice day. I still got a ways to go. A ways to go. Granola bar. I packed away my lunch meat. Pulled a Joe. Alright, time to head on.
Look how open that is now. Sketchy. Oh, there's the exit. I can see some guys ice fishing over there. I'm gonna go check it out, see if they can show me how deep the ice is. Oh man, I'm here. I'm sweaty. Thirsty and tired too. Oh my God, there's not even any snow left in the parking lot. This is crazy.
Up. Good dog. See him struggle there? Lay down, okay, bud?
Okay. Well, I talked to those ice fishermen. They were locals, and they said that the weather forecast is going to be 10 degrees Celsius again today, 8 the next day, 5 the next day, 5 the next day, all well above zero for the next, like, 5 or 6 days. But, on the other hand, I was able to check the thickness of the ice, and it was still well over a foot deep, thick, so that's not an issue. But I am glad I'm leaving. This is not my idea of winter camping, when I could walk around in a t-shirt, especially when I have a campus tent and a wood stove and all that stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Look out soon. I'm going to do another camping trip with my family, a winter camping trip in a hot tent. I'll be using a bigger hot tent, a different hot tent. So we'll be doing that really soon, and that video will be up very soon as well. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you on the next one. It's always a nice sound.